Thanks for checking out this episode of Brewtal Battle Beer Break. Today I'm going to be doing a brewery that I've not done before. It is The Brewery out of Orange County, California. So it says on the label, actually out of Placentia, California to be specific. This beer is their take on a Gueuze-style sour. It is called Rueuze, and Rue, the Rue portion of the name, is a play off the last name of the founder of the company. His name's Patrick Rue, and they do that with a bunch of their beer names. They have one called like Saison de Rue, stuff like that. 5.6% alcohol by volume for this, their take on a Gueuze. And it was three different vintages of their sour blonde ale that were mixed together. But then the interesting thing is this bottle from the bottling date is actually like a year and a half old almost. So it was three different vintages and then a year and a half after that for this. So see how it is? Check it out. I've only had like one Gueuze, I think one Gueuze prior to this, and it was by Tilquin Gueuzery, their Oud Gueuze, so, which I understand is a very good example of a Gueuze. So there you go, so you can see the bottle. Very orangey. You can see right through it, super filtered. Got a decent white head to it. Ooh, yeah, just get smacked with that sour aspect to it. Oh, man, it kind of smells like sweet tarts, you know? Like citrusy sweet tarts. There's a lot of lemon aspect to it in there. Super sour. And there's kind of like an oak aspect. Oh, okay. It's aged in oak barrels. Okay. Well, that makes sense why I'm smelling an oak aspect to it. Because there's like a little bit of a vanilla-y, oaky note to it. Ooh. That sourness is good. It kind of like pangs on your palate like real quick. Like a sharp, quick sourness of like, you know, lemony aspect to it. And then it backs off and you get that kind of nice oak and like vanilla aspect from the oak. It doesn't, you know, like some sours will just kind of like overpower your palate and just kind of stay on there with the sourness. But like I said, you know, it hits your palate real quick with some sourness and then it backs off and it's that oak. Mm. As far as sour beers go, that is nice. I'm a fan. That's good. For anyone who likes, you know, kind of a sour flavor, but they don't want sour to just overtake their mouths, this would be a very good option. The price point's a little bit on the higher end. I think it's around $20 or so for a liquor store, I believe. So, you know, make up your mind on that, whether you want to do it or not. But you're going to pay more for beers that take this type of, you know, time to make. So, anyway, I would say definitely check it out. If people, you know, if you like sour style beers, and especially if you like oak barrel aged sour beers, do it. I don't think there's anything else interesting to put on to put out there about this, but the oak barrel aging, which I had forgotten in the beginning. Well, actually, I didn't even know, but was picking it up. It does say things about cellaring on the back, which is really great. I know the brewery really tries to optimize the flavor of their beers. They're very into, you know, saying this is how you should enjoy it, so that's why the cellaring information is on the back. Good job, the brewery. Damn, this is a nice beer. I'm going to sip on this and edit an episode of Brewtal Battle. Everybody, thank you for checking this out, and stick around for the next time. But more importantly, go get yourself an awesome beer. Enjoy it.